So students, now we are going to revise our next chapter, that is chapter 13, that is Handicrafts of West India. Handicrafts of West India. Now here we were talking about West India. West India is which part of a country? West India means we were talking about Gujarat or Rajasthan, they comes in West India. Even Maharashtra also comes in West India only. Fine. East, West, North and then South. So here we were talking about the West one. Now India is rich in culture and craft, well depicted in its handicrafts, be it decorative pieces, jewelry or clothes. Now the handicrafts are famous the world over. Now, if I will talk about handicrafts, handicrafts means the craft which is done by hand. And here in this handicraft, we will include your painting also, we will include your embroidery also, we will include the work which is done. Handicraft means it is not only with embroidery, it is not only with painting. Whatever things which we are making or the something that is creative, that is different from that machine work. So that is known as handicraft. It can be done in jewelry also, it can be done on clothes also, it can be done in shoes also, it can be done on bags also. So in our country, if you will find it out, that Rajasthan and Gujarat are quite famous for that. Rajasthan and Gujarat, these two states are quite famous for their handicrafts. If you will went to Jaipur or Udaipur or that places of some certain regions of Rajasthan, you just find it out that they have such a huge kind of a culture and that handicrafts. You have heard about Suraj Kund Mela also. That Suraj Kund Mela is there in that in Rajasthan only. And if we'll talk about Surat doesn't need any introduction regarding this handicraft and all. So that is very important, handicrafts. Now here you can see the identify the some of the well-known handicrafts from the western states of India. You can find it out that one picture you can see. You can see that picture which is done on a piece of a cloth, and this cloth is quite famous for what kind of a work, that is B. Here you have been given with the help box also on the next page, that is carved, that is that is what kind of a craft is this. So that is B. Fine. And then we can come to the jewelry also. Jewelry also, if you'll find it out, that is abla. The first one is abla mirror embroidery in Gujarat. And then the next is that you can see this kind of a embroidery, you will find it out, this jewelry, that kind of a, that is a artwork which is done on stones. Then the third one is the Kolhapuri chappal, which is quite famous, that is comes from Maharashtra. The third one is that Kolhapuri. So these are the quite famous. If I talk about now, that handmade Kolhapuri leather footwear which comes from Maharashtra. Basically, if I talk about this, all these artwork, all these handicraft, so I'm going to talk about only the three states, that is Gujarat, Rajasthan and Maharashtra. So these artwork will be done over there only in Gujarat, in Maharashtra, and in Rajasthan. This Kolhapuri famous leather sleepers were from Kolhapur, which is a city in Maharashtra. Again, this silk artwork you can see on the clothes. Silk saris again, which is a brand of Gujarat only, silk work. Then we have this wooden work, also you will find it out over there only. Now a container you can see, and that silk work again you can find it out. Now if you will see the screen, you just find it out that answers are already written over there, L, M, D, and from there you can write the answer and then you can match those answers from the help box. You can match the answers from the help box. See, these kind of a container usually you are not going to find it out. These containers are quite famous because they are made up of Bichom village pottery, Goa. That is some kind of a, like number 8 also you can see, 8th picture if you will see. You can see that 8th picture. That is of a silk sari, which you will find it out. From where you will find it out, that silk sari? That is Kota Doria cotton weave from Rajasthan. From Rajasthan you will get this Kota Doria cotton weave. That is quite famous. Now wooden furniture also, that is quite famous from Goa. In a Goa we will get a certain kind of a furnitures, which nowadays usually you are not going to find it out. And this is your unit 3 in your book. Bangles also, if I'll come to 15th, that is bangle. And bangle is again, seashell craft also, that is quite famous. This seashell craft also, this you can see that Ganpati and even those different idols can be made with that seashell. Then this silk also, silk saris also will be formed. Now what you have to remember, you have to remember the particular state which is famous for. If I'll talk apart from these pictures which have been given in your book, apart from that you must be knowing that in Rajasthan, that is bandhani, that saris, bandhani kind of a saris, bandhani saris were quite famous from Rajasthan. And the sleepers which are formed with the skin of camel, oot ki jo skin hoti hai, uske jo sleepers form hote, that is again very famous from Rajasthan. Jutiyan banai jati hai usse. And all these things are quite famous from Rajasthan. Bandhani and this Rajasthani, Jaipuri, Rajai and all blankets, those are quite famous. Again, they come in handicrafts also. Some of that it is used in machines, but rest of that is used by, or that was done with the hands only. So all these things are quite important. You all will learn about all these things. And in this video we have revised first three unit, unit 1, that is unit 1, then this is my India, then unit 2, famous women, and then this unit 3, that is handicraft, famous handicrafts of West India. Now the whole country is divided into 4 part: North India, South India, East India and West India, and they were sharing different culture also. So this handicrafts are quite important for that all. You will revise these 3 units, and problems we are going to take it in the online class. So here I am going to finish the class for today. So that's all for today, children. I hope the things which we have done today, that is quite clear to you all. And if we will be having some doubt, see, Current affairs you are going to learn on daily basis. You will read newspaper, watch television at once, and that will be that you will do it. And apart from that, you will be doing that learning. Subscribe any one current affairs channel and study current affairs from that. So that will help you for your GK exam. That's all for today, children. Have a good day. So students, as you all are aware that we were doing revision of your GK book, and already we have revised few of the chapters. Next is unit 4, that is Union Territories. Now children, there are 28 states and 9 Union Territories in India. Now earlier we have 29 states, but now Jammu and Kashmir became a Union Territory. So now here the number of states will be 28 states and 9 Union Territories. Now the states have their own elected government, whereas the Union Territories are ruled directly by the Union government or the central government. Means whatever will be happen in Union Territory, that will be took up by a central government. Now what do you mean by state government and central government? So first of all, I'll talk about state government. State government means when we were talking about the government which was owned by the state. For example, a state is having a chief minister, just like that in central government we have our prime minister. In the same case, from our that state government we have a chief minister, and that chief minister combined with that cabinet ministry also a set of peoples, those who rule or those who defined all the rules among the cabinet. So they were ruling our state government, as well as this same kind of format we will having with a central government. Now if I'll talk about our state, we'll take an example of our state, and then we are going to understand about state government and central government. Central government is same for all. Like in central government we have our prime minister, then we have a cabinet ministry also, and they have like central minister of railways, central minister of finance, central minister of that is for that cloth and product industries. So they all are central minister, but with that only we have state minister also, state railway minister, state industry ministers, state agriculture minister. And these state ministers are taking care of their states only. Like whosoever will be railway minister of our state, they are going to take care of their state only. They are going to take care of Uttar Pradesh only. But the centralized railway minister is going to make rule for the whole country. So they were governing their state government and they will be ruled by it. But Union Territories directly comes in the rule of central government. There we have there we do not have chief minister. There we have only governor Uprajyapal. They are known as Uprajyapal. Fine, they were only we were having. Now here we will be having, can you identify the Union Territories discussed below? Now for the first one is, these are a group of islands at the juncture of the Bay of Bengal and Andaman Sea. Cellular Jail and Mahatma Gandhi Marine National Park
are some of their major tourist attraction. Now here you can see in the picture, now I think this first picture was quite clear, Andaman and Nicobar Island. Now few of the important tourist attractions we have seen, Andaman and Nicobar Island. Earlier it was known as a Kala Pani also. If anyone want to give punishment, they were kept over there. Or this cellular jail was quite famous. This cellular jail where Mahatma Gandhi was kept also. So Mahatma Gandhi Marine National Park is also quite famous over there. These are the few major tourist attractions. But nowadays Andaman and Nicobar, the people are not keeping over there because that island is, as you all are knowing, the verbal meaning of island means a piece of a land which is covered with water. So if we are not going to carry anything over there, we do not, after some time we do not have anything to eat over there, to drink over there. That's why it is known as a Kala Pani, as a punishment area, that they will not be provided with anyone, anything. So that is there. So that is again an important thing, that these are a group of islands. And you know that is about 53 to 54 islands were there in Andaman and Nicobar. Small islands were there. And capital of Andaman and Nicobar Island is Port Blair. Capital of Andaman and Nicobar Island is Port Blair. Now we'll come to next. Now the next one is number 2. This park is quite famous park. That is that all the this structures were made up of stones. Fine. And rock garden. This is known as rock garden, and it is quite a famous rock garden from a union territory. Can you name that union territory? That is union territory, that is where you will find it out. This rock garden is Chandigarh. Now it serves as the capital of the two states, Punjab and Haryana. This you all were knowing it also. Now first important thing, it was the first planned city of India. And it is known internationally for its architecture and urban design. Urban design means the how the width of a road is decided, a proper width of a road, proper houses, proper that water treatment plants and water sanitary, or everything was keep it in their minds, and then this Union Territory was designed. If you will went to Chandigarh, you just find it out that a proper spacing between the houses, they were constructed in a same pattern. Amount of now here if you will go now, you will find it out that they are making of their own design. But there the that pattern of designing the houses, that is same for each. And they have to leave some area in front of it, and they have to leave some area at their back also, backyard also. So they will be having such kind of a structure. So Chandigarh is the union territory which serves as a capital for two states, that is Punjab and Haryana. Let's come to the third picture. That is third picture. You can see this third picture. It is an union territory in western India. These are two places included in this union territory. The first place is located between Maharashtra and Gujarat, whereas the second place is surrounded by Gujarat. Their shared capital is Silvassa, that is Dadar and Nagar Haveli. Dadar and Nagar Haveli. Dadar and Nagar Haveli, these are two places. First place is located between Maharashtra and Gujarat, and whereas the second place is surrounded by Gujarat, fine, and they have their shared capital. Dadar and Nagar Haveli, they are two places, but they are sharing a common capital, that is Silvassa. Silvassa is their common capital. So that also you are going to remember, and I hope that is clear to you all. Now we'll come to number 4. Mostly these area, Dadar and Nagar Haveli, is famous for their ship. They are getting most of their work done by ships only. Most of the people, they came at Dadar and Nagar Haveli by ships. So that those ships are quite important for them. Now we'll come to fourth picture. For over 450 years, both the places here were a part of Portuguese occupied India. For over 450 years, that is very important, 450 years, both the places, Daman and Diu, both the places were a part of Portuguese. Portuguese came in our country before Britishers, and earlier they were ruling different parts of our country, not only this Goan part and all. They were ruling some part from a northeast also and southern part also. But when Britishers have came, then Britishers started fighting with Portuguese. When that the First World War, which was started, not only that First World War, before that, the war which was started in 17th century, 17 something, in other part of America, that at that same time that impact came here in India also. So in 1750 or 1741 to 45, when the war was beginning over there only, then at that time they were fighting here also. They were in that mood only here also in India, and then Britishers started capturing the areas which was occupied by Portuguese, and lastly Portuguese were limited till Goa only, and they have ruled Goa, even Daman and Diu also, for about 450 years. Later on they have left Daman and Diu also, but Goa doesn't got its independence. Goa got its independence in 1965. Goa is, when our country got independence, Goa was still in the slavery of Portuguese people, and our Goa got his freedom, its freedom in the year 1965, 31st December 1965. So after that Portuguese went to their country, and then Goa came in the country, or came in the rule of Indian government. So this, now see, they were incorporated into the Republic of India on 19 December 1961 by military conquest. See this Daman and Diu. Now we'll come to fifth picture. Fifth picture is, it was formerly known as the Minicoy and Aminidivi Islands. Now it is a group of islands that is about 200 to 440 kilometers off the southwestern coast of India, forming the smallest union territory. Now this is the smallest union territory, that is Lakshadweep. Lakshadweep is the smallest union territory, and they occupy about 200 to 440 kilometers of the southwestern coast of India. So that is again an important thing, that smallest union territory it is formed, and that is Lakshadweep. Minicoy, earlier the formally known name is Minicoy or Amindiv Islands. Now we'll come to sixth picture. It is one of the most populous city. Populous means most of the population is quite high. It has served as the capital of India, various kingdom and empires. Capital of India, as well as it serves as the capital of various kingdoms and empires. They all want to rule Delhi. Even the Muslim emperor, most of the Muslim emperor, they want to rule Delhi, and that Delhi will become sultanate for many of the Muslim rulers. So New Delhi is well known for its culture. The Muslim emperor and different emperor, not only Muslim, Rajput emperor and many more, they have ruled Delhi, and they have given lot of architect, lot of culture to New Delhi. We found many monument in New Delhi. We found Red Fort, we found Qutub Minar. All these architecture was well known from the government, from the rulers, those who have their kingdom over there. So they have made lot many architecture in that. Okay, now the seventh one is the Union Territory comprises of four small unconnected districts. In 1674, it became a French colonial possession. In 1954, it was included in the territory of India. It was the residence of Sri Aurobindo, whose ashram still operates from here. That is Puducherry. The Union Territory comprises of four small unconnected districts. In 1674, it became a French colony possession. In 1954, it was included in the territory of India. It was the residence of Sri Aurobindo, whose ashram still operates from here. That is known as Puducherry. Now, Puducherry, in 1674, it became a French colonial position, but they have included in our territory of India in the year 1954. Now, the eighth picture is of our Jammu and Kashmir, which was recently become Union Territory. On 5th August 2019, the government dissolved Article 370. This is very important, that on 5th August 2019, the government dissolved Article 370 of the Constitution of India, bifurcated the states into two union territories and notified that this UT shall now be a union territory with its own legislature, similar to how Puducherry and Delhi are administrated. In the case of this union territory, it will be self-administered government with a legislature. What do you mean by legislature? Legislature means their own cabinet ministry, their own self-government that will be formed. And on 5th August 2019, the government dissolved this Article 370, and then this Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh, these two, Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh, two union territories will be formed. So before that we have seven, but after forming this Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh, now the total number of union territory is 9. Now this union territory was carved out of the former state of Jammu and Kashmir on 5th August 2019. Now it is sparsely populated with a very difficult terrain. Now this UT will be without a legislature, means that legislature is not there. They were governing by the central government and they are going to form by that self-administered government. They are not form their own government, they will be governed by the central government only. So carved out of former state of Jammu Kashmir on 5th August 2019, and it is sparsely